Hey, good morning. Welcome to your Thursday, 30th day of May. We getting started with social media prayer time. I hope you can join us. Meanwhile, it's Hillsong with Oceans. Enjoy the music and we'll talk to you, pray with you in just a few minutes.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith would be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Take me deeper.
real song in Australia. It's called Oceans on the Kingdom Messenger Network World Radio. Hey, good morning. As we head over to the video side and join them and say good morning. Just give me a second to do that. And hey, good morning. So glad you can join us. You're listening to Social Media Prayer Time on the Kingdom Messenger Network Web Radio. Fading out a long song that doesn't want to fade. Always such an honor to have you join us, whether you're live or across the table. Good morning, Mother. Mm-hmm. Or joining us all over the world. God bless you. Thank you so much for making a point to pray with us here. It really does mean a difference to see y'all here, to connect and praise God with you. And, you know, it's just awesome. So thank you so much for actively taking part as Robert's testifying on one side and then the ladies are going on the other side. So it's really awesome. Thank you so much. Need to see y'all awake and ready to give God honor and praise, which we love to do. Opening up with good news from the Word of God. I've been stuck here. I took Anna's Message Bible and been reading it alongside this other Bible my mom brought. And this just, wow, this is so awesome. It's Matthew 5 where the Beatitudes come from it. This is from the Message version. It's amazing. Are you ready? All right. Matthew chapter 5 in the Message. I have to say that because it's so different. When Jesus saw his ministry drawing huge crowds, he climbed a hillside. Those who were apprenticed to him, the committed, climbed with him. Arriving at a quiet place, he sat down and taught his climbing companions. This is what he said. You're blessed when you're at the end of your rope. With less of you, there is more of God and his rule. You're blessed when you feel you've lost what is most dear to you. Only then can you be embraced by the one most dear to you. You're blessed when you're content with just who you are, no more, no less. That's the moment you find yourselves proud owners of everything that can't be bought. You're blessed when you've worked up a good appetite for God. He's food and drink and the best meal you'll ever eat. You're blessed when you care. At the moment of being careful, you find yourself cared for. You're blessed when you get your inside world, your mind and your heart put right. Then you can see God in the outside world. You're blessed when you can show people how to cooperate instead of compete or fight. That's when you discover who you really are and your place in God's family. You're blessed when your commitment to God provokes persecution. Persecution drives you ever deeper into God's kingdom. Lord, we just bless you and praise you and thank you for a fresh look at your word, Lord. And I just thank you that you have a way of saying it, Lord, and not, don't get too hung up on versions, but that just is speaking, I don't know how to say it, in just a fresh, different way. And I know I've thought of the Beatitudes before, but I thank you for speaking so preciously, so dearly to my heart. And I pray, Lord, that as we activate, as we speak those words over people, this morning, over messengers, over men and women who are committed to you, Lord, I pray that that will just release into their lives, Lord. The travel companions, we're all travel companions, we're all walking the same road, we all want to see people get saved. I know there's many family members here that would love for their daughter or their son to come back or to experience salvation. So we lift them up humbly and lift up those family members that others are standing in the gap, believing for their salvation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Continue to stand in the gap for the kingdom of God to come. Your kingdom come, your will be done. The full manifestation of the kingdom and all its design and frequencies and dimensions of bringing salvation, of bringing healing, of bringing deliverance, the blind see. Hallelujah. That is so, Lord, what we desire in our heart to see. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yeshua, thank you, Father God. We bless you and we praise you. And Father, when we experience heartache, when we experience maybe persecution for the sake of the gospel or misunderstandings or pain, Lord, I thank you that you are near to the brokenhearted. You save those who are crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, it says in Psalm 34, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. Maybe someone watching recorded or live, just going through affliction, going through pain, going through a need for God to bring deliverance. Lord, I thank you they're listening right now. I don't think it's an accident. We thank you that we can decree and declare that God is bigger than their problem. God is bigger than what might seem like a wide place in between two things, whether that's two things or two people, two issues, or a financial problem, a marriage problem. Lord, you're bigger. And you, by your power of your Holy Spirit, I believe you can bring provision, you can bring union, you can bring the restoration in the name of Jesus. As we continue to pray, we lift up provision for the vision. That's one of the areas that we were committed to pray. We also pray for our C list. Add Carmen to that C list. Y'all remember Carmen? Remember Carmen, Mom, the singer?
Mm-hmm.
He's been battling cancer for quite some time, and he shares on Facebook, and he had a rough day the other day. So we lift up Carmen and believe for deliverance. Thank you for even in the midst of his pain and his anguish, he continued to testify of the power of Jesus Christ. Pray for Carly and Carla, Dave from Seattle, those that we've been believing you, God, to touch their bodies. We won't call it cancer list. We'll call it the C list, the Christ list, because Jesus is able in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Continue to lift up Wanda. I haven't heard how her knee surgery went. I hadn't heard yet. Continue to pray for Bryn, who's in the hospital, believing God you to touch that little child's body in the name of Jesus. Lord, we unite with prayer with another prayer group. Their specific purpose is to unite to pray against, the sex trade with children. Talked to a gentleman, or Dave did, and then I did, and they're united. They want to be united in prayer for that specific purpose, and I said, we will join with them and continue to pray in the name of Jesus Christ for deliverance and safety for these young people. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we love you. We bless you today. And just thank you for being able, Lord, to meet the needs, however devastating they may seem. In the name of Jesus, I just thank you for you're enough, Lord. I thank you that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. I thank you for the power that comes with the Holy Spirit that's alive in us. And Lord, as we continue to go forth today with an attitude of gratitude, as we continue to pray and press in, I thank you that you are able. I thank you that you're there to carry the wounded heart. We play this song, this old song from Amy Grant. It's called Carry You from the Kingdom Messenger Network Web Radio. God bless you.
My child, my child.
I've done a thousand things you've never done. And I'm weary watching while you struggle on your own. Call my name, oh come. Lay down your burden.
Definitely a classic. It's Amy Grant with Carry You from the Kingdom Messenger Network Web Radio. Social media prayer time. Will you join us again? I hope so.